Hi everybody, feel very welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to discover how to run Toca Life World on PC. Now you are watching it on screen. It takes almost no time to easily download and set up Toca Life World so that we can play the game on our Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the current URL that I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's a clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed below on our Usitility website, where we have a comprehensive summary on just how to download and install Toca Life World on PC. We scroll down a little bit as well as click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we land here on the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Toca Life World on our PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of pros of using that emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we are ready to proceed to download the Toca Life World by simply clicking on this button, Download Toca Life World on PC, that I have marked in green. Next step is clicking on that button. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do now is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the system. We clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installation software is straightforward. It includes two possibilities: install and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We basically click on it. And therefore we note that we have now here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we would like to change this directory, we must click on this browse option. And now we decide on another directory and set up the emulator wherever we desire. To keep it simple, just leave it where it is. I click on back. Therefore I just click install. At this time, prior to starting installing that emulator, will also be possible that it's going to present us a number of computer software offers to add on the laptop. Since I do not desire any of those software programs, I merely click several times on the reject option. Fantastic! The setup begins and it's going to progress in the download of those megabytes which are displayed on this computer screen. Once you download it, it could be more or less MB. The data transfer speed may go faster or at a lower speed, depending on your type of connection and according to the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're going super fast. The download is done, then at this time it continues with the setup procedure. The installation will require more or less time depending on the strength of your machine. The more powerful it's actually, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we join the download and installation phase, it normally takes quite a long time, so have patience. It is by now completely finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be launched immediately. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will move forward to the right, and once it actually reaches the end, the emulator is going to be launched for the very first time. Indeed, the emulator has been launched, here for the very first time. And as a result, LD Store is instantly launched, that is a sort of Google Play. It isn't really the optimal method to set up the game, therefore I really don't suggest it, merely because from time to time the LD Store puts an obsolete version of the video game. I will explain to you the right way to install the video game utilizing the Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we have to accomplish is to head to the computer's desktop by pressing this icon that I am pointing out in green. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it made two app icons there on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon will be the one we're concerned about. Anytime we need to run Toca Life World on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this app icon and use the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even nearly anything like this. Indeed, it is an icon that we might certainly never start using. Shall we conduct the following step, which is actually a must-have, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To execute this, we will browse here to System Apps, we click on. And we are going to just click on Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is started. Right here we must log on. So now once we are right here, we must definitely execute the next step that is mandatory. So that we mouse click on Sign In. Presently it shows Checking Info. It may in some cases get stopped at Checking Info, That's why it doesn't move ahead. In this case, you may try to connect to your account after a number of hours, it's going to most likely be repaired. At this time, we're going to insert our email and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For instance, you make use of the same email you are using at this moment in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to enter my details and I will revisit after I have completed it. Voila! Info inserted. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We will agree to them by simply clicking, I agree. Following that, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it selected and it'll produce a backup of the files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. By now Google Play is started by default and immediately. However, if the Google Play is simply not started automatically and you don't know how to launch it yourself, I guide you towards how to get it done. Firstly is to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon designated in green. Straight away we head to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Yes, we are there inside of Google Play. What we shall perform will be go here to search for apps and games. And thus we are going to do a search for Toca Life World. Now there we have got it, we must select the first result. Listed here we have got the video game. Let's quickly mouse click now on the install option that I'm displaying now in green. That click will commence the setup. At this time it is going to download and install the game. It usually takes a while or perhaps it may possibly be extremely fast. It again all will depend on our own connection to the internet. It's already finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking this particular option I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can launch Toca Life World for the first time. You are now on the emulator desktop, and then we're on the way to just click that new Toca Life World app icon that has been generated. Your game app is launched for the very first time. So there we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the volume level of this emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the max, we should activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is actually the first one. We mouse click on that app icon that I am actually mentioning in green. Thus the monitor is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Granted that we need to have fun with the app using all the screen, we click this particular app icon. And we might at present be experiencing the Android game in 100% screen setting. To leave the 100% screen mode, hit the F11 key. And additionally we would certainly at present end up being in standard display screen mode. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate to you the keys mapping and that is certainly quite appealing. This way we will likely be ready to utilize the game application more effortlessly. The very first point is to click on this keyboard icon. It's now time to get the appropriate controls. I'll go ahead and keep the default configuration, but if you really want to improve it, you may well achieve it without having problem. I grab this occasion to comment that occasionally, when opening the game application a black screen appears. If that is so and you experience the black display and the emulator is unable to begin, I suggest a potential answer. We can click here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator preferences, in the advanced choice we have got quite a lot of resolutions. That is the resolution we have currently specified automatically and we must choose any of these other screen resolutions, for instance that one below. We take it and after that mouse click save. It will certainly tell us to restart the emulator and when restarted, probably the emulator will start up and the black display screen will vanish. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is started in the wrong language, as an example, in Chinese. And as a consequence to place it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus there inside of various other controls, we just click that language, drop down. We may decide on the language we like, English, Japanese, and so forth. Once the language is determined, we would save, the emulator will reboot, along with the game, the next time we use it, would as well be in the picked language. So now, you can find another element that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email indicating that a new equipment has been connected with our Google account. It will definitely ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Yes, we may not worry, considering that the emulator is acting as an Android smartphone or tablet. So you can find which electronic device is currently being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Let's browse here to the, model, choice. And there we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it, guys. So much for that video tutorial. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, particularly that you found it useful. In this case, bring it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have remarks, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment area below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel. I perform live streams occasionally. You have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of the videos that are showing up on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming training videos. Bye.